Hi guys, after the fantastic response I got from my video on how to upgrade to Windows 10, I thought I'd be a bit more productive and get onto the beta program for the next version of Windows, so I could bring you secret information before its release. But after some digging, I got some surprising news. Now I'm sure some of you are already aware, but for those who haven't heard, Microsoft have announced that Windows 10 will be the last version of Windows which they release for the desktop computer. Now this means that there will not be a Windows 11 coming out anytime soon. Instead, improvements and revisions will be released each month as Windows updates. This is known as Windows as a Service. It's a new concept introduced with the release of Windows 10. So there are five definitions of the Windows updates. The one we all look forward to is the feature update. As the name suggests, these updates deliver new features to Windows 10 and they're released 2 to 3 times a year. Next is the quality update. These updates deliver both security, which are deemed as critical, and non-security bug fixes. Patching these is like patching the Golden Gate Bridge. As fast as Microsoft patch, vulnerabilities are exposed. Fortunately, these are cumulative, meaning you only need to install the latest version, rather than requiring all versions to be installed in order. Such as if you had Service Pack 5, you don't need to install Service Pack 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. You can go straight to 5. And these are the main updates which are released each month. Next is the Insider Preview. This is how I get my builds early as a tester for Microsoft. These updates are made available during the development of the features that will be shipped with the next feature update. This allows me to validate new features, as well as compatibility testing with existing applications and current infrastructure. The final definitions are aimed at IT departments with an automated deployment process in place. These are out of scope for this series, but I think they're worth a quick mention. The first is servicing branches. Branching allows the IT department to test with a pilot environment before installing on the masses. A good example of this would be a single user from each department would be in a pilot group. The pilot group would get the latest updates, and after sufficient testing, the build gets deployed to the rest of the users, and the pilot group would then get the next updates to test. The idea here is that if the pilot group has problems, it doesn't affect the rest of the users. Which brings us on to the final definition, which is deployment rings. This is basically delivering the update releases in phases to ensure adequate testing before releasing into a live environment. If you want to know more on this, I suggest you look at the Microsoft TechNet site. Now, the aim of these videos is to inform you monthly of what these updates are and to highlight any new or deprecating features. And based on the requests for future videos from you guys and the questions and comments I receive, I'll try to include some tips and tricks at the end of each video. So please keep an eye out for those. Now, the Microsoft updates are released on the second Tuesday of each month, so I shall endeavour to post a video around this time. Rather than using the build numbers which Microsoft released them with, I shall refer to these updates in my videos by their release dates. Now, first thing I'll say is if you're used to doing something a specific way in Windows, when a new method or feature is introduced, learn it. Because the chances are that the new way will become the normal way. So my advice, learn the new way and stop clinging on to what you know, because it's last year's technology and will probably soon become a deprecated feature. Here's what I mean. If you've not already met, let me introduce you to the Sleek Settings app, basically the new control panel. I'm not sure if the original control panel will be deprecated soon, but for now, both are present. However, all the help options within Windows 10 seem to direct you to this new setting app as opposed to the control panel. If you don't know your way around it, you'll probably revert back to the control panel anyway, but you need to find out how the new system is going to work. So if we click Start, and on the Settings cog, there's the Windows Settings app. The shortcut for this is the Windows key and I. Click on System, and then About. Now to identify the version of Windows we're using, look at Version. The first two digits represent the year of release, and digits 3 and 4 represent the month. So in this example, the release I'm using is July 2016. We can get more granular with identifying our version of Windows by the build number. If you have the original version of Windows, you'll just see 10240, as this was the initial release for Windows 10. Although chances are you've already done some updates and the build number has changed. We can also get this information by using the winver command in the Katana. Just type winver. As you can see, we've got the version number and the build number, and also the version of Windows itself. However, this doesn't tell you the architecture. So also on this page, we've got the edition. At the time of recording, Windows 10 editions included Home, Professional, Enterprise and Education. If you have the Home edition, you can upgrade to Professional from within Windows 10 by this link. But if you want to switch to Enterprise or Education, it needs a complete new reinstall, and also you need to get a new product key, which isn't available to home users. The next line on here is the system type. This tells you your architecture. And just to clear any confusion, 64-bit is not twice as fast as 32-bit. It's increased exponentially, meaning that the increased factor is compounded. So if we double the speed of 32-bit, we'd get 33-bit. And again, if we double 33-bit, we'd get 34-bit. And if we double 34-bit, we'd get 35-bit and so on. Now you can see how considerably faster a 64-bit computer is. Why would you choose to go for a 32-bit? Obviously, your computer hardware must support 64-bit. And you can check this by the base processor here. These days, I think you'll have to try hard to find a modern PC which doesn't support 64-bit. If your computer was made after 2010, and it's still reported that it doesn't support 64-bit, the chances are the feature is probably turned off in the BIOS. If this is the case, put it in a comment and we can exchange a few emails and I'll try to help you enable it. So the options here would be a 64-bit operating system with a 64-bit processor. Indicates you're using a 64-bit version of Windows on a 64-bit machine. 32-bit operating system on a 64-bit processor. Indicates that you're using the 32-bit version, but you can install Windows 10 64-bit. And then the final one is 32-bit operating system and a 32-bit based computer. As I said earlier, on a modern computer, this indicates you're using 32-bit version of Windows, and you may be able to enable the 64-bit capability within the BIOS and could then install 64-bit version on your computer. I guess this is a good time to say that if you have done the free upgrade to Windows 10 from your previous version of Windows, unfortunately, you're stuck with whatever architecture was on that previous version of Windows. So if you had Windows 7 32-bit and you've done the upgrade, you will have Windows 10 32-bit. If you want the 64-bit, the architecture change is not included in the free upgrade, so you're going to have to purchase a new copy. I hope this video has been informative for you, and I look forward to bringing you the next video next month. Bye for now.